Hi everyone, happy Monday. Great to be with you again today. Hope y'all had a great weekend. We actually were in Boise, Idaho this weekend attending a family wedding. Really liked it there, huh, Jerry?
And the rumors have started.
What's that?
Well, there were a couple of comments where people have said, why are you in Boise?
And,
you know, ? And all that kind of fun stuff. It was pretty funny.
Oh, wow. I didn't hear that. But someone actually did mention while we were there, how does Ida Kim sound? Want to move to Boise? And I said, no, I think we're staying in California. We're pretty good with Cali Kim. But our nephew got married. Drew was in the wedding. It was a great time. Loved all the trees there. Loved the fall colors that we got to see. It did rain all day Saturday, the day of the wedding, but it was still a lot of fun. We managed to stay dry, but we were pretty cold. I was only about 60 degrees, I think, on Saturday. And came home to some cool weather, too.
Yeah, it was my first time there as well. I was pleasantly surprised, but really what a cool city it is. And it seems pretty laid back, but a little teaser as what's gonna come this week. I grabbed the candy bar there and I haven't eaten it yet. It's called the Idaho Spud, I think. I have no idea what it's gonna taste like. And I think I'm gonna make a reel of me taking a bite of this chocolate bar. I don't know.
Maybe candy bar?
Yeah, maybe somebody knows here. They know this candy bar. So anyway, be watching for that. I'm not sure what it's going to lead to.
That'll be interesting. Well, if Cliff was here, he might be able to fill you in on that.
True.
But unfortunately, he's not able to be here today, but he said hello and then he misses you all.
Yep.
We do have Nisha here, our other moderator.
Yep.
Super glad to see her as we are every single week.
Yep.
And Smart Pots is here in the chat.
Yay.
We've got Jeff from Smart Pots.
I saw Jeff.
And Smart Pots is here as well on their own YouTube channel. So great to have y'all here. We always like to give lots of resources, and Smart Pots is definitely the container garden expert for you to ask questions to.
Yes,
so
they
welcome.
Are. Yep, always good to have them.
So we're gonna say hello in just a moment, but I just just wanted to mention what today's topic is all about. It's gonna be a fun one. It's October, so happy October. And we're gonna talk about what to do in the garden in October, some essentials that you don't wanna miss. So grab your pen and paper, be ready to take some notes, and send the link to a friend that can join in with us and have a great time in the chat. So let's jump in and say hello to those of you that are here. We always love to hang out with you here on Monday. So thanks for starting your week with us. Bruce is here. Should have tried some spud nuts while you were there.
Oh.
Donuts, I think, right?
Oh. That
I think we just saw Krispy Kreme, but I know those spud nut shops are all over the place as well.
Yeah, I saw a couple of other comments too. They're going by really fast, so I'm sorry I didn't catch any of them. I think Janice said, yeah, that candy bar's been around for a while. So,
okay.
All right. Well, we'll see what it's all about for sure.
It'll be fun. It's a new one to us. Let's see. Terry is here. Is there a potato in it? Chocolate dipped potato chips. That sounds pretty good, actually.
Yep.
I think we've had chocolate Pringles before. Stephanie Presley, hello from Missouri. Thank you so much for joining us. Miriam, never been to Idaho. Maybe a future road trip.
Definitely worth it.
Yeah,
sure.
Definitely worth
really
it. Our son actually drove with a friend.
I saw a
and
Michigan,
they had a great time.
Sorry. I saw a Michigan person there. Who is that? I can't read. There we go. Gardening for Better Health. Hey, hello from Michigan.
Great to have you here. Jennifer, hi from London. Wow, that's always fun.
Cool.
Always get to see people from all over the world.
Yeah, let's see. So if you're in London, that means it's kind of getting late there for you. So thanks for being on. Really cool.
I think they're 8 hours maybe.
Yep. So for those of you who receive our subscription box, we're going to talk about that just for a quick moment or two here. You should have received yours by now. So I want you to say in the chat what you opened up and what was your favorite part of this month's box. It's a really special box, as you've heard, especially with the container that Smart Pots made for this. Kim, do you want to
vanna that right here?
So
sorry.
That's okay.
Go ahead.
So just put in, go ahead and show it.
October, for those of you who don't know, is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and Smart Pots made this very special pot to commemorate breast cancer awareness.
Yep.
And a dollar from the proceeds of each box actually goes towards breast cancer research this month.
Yep.
So I really appreciate all your support. First box has already started shipping out, but we will be shipping throughout the month.
Yep. So we've received lots of comments, but put it now in the chat. What part of the box was really special for you? May have been something different there. And Kim, if you can kind of help keep that chat window up,
we
can read the comments and let's see what people say. You know, Charlene made it from Spain. Okay, we can proceed now because Charlene's here. All right.
All right. Way
it's
to
also
go,
late
Charlene.
For Charlene. So we have a London person and we have a Spain person here. Awesome.
Thanks for staying up with us.
Yep.
Let's see. Terry got hers and loves a lovely Smart Pot was her favorite thing.
Nice.
So glad you got it, Terry.
Yep.
And let's
Charlene
see.
Also said it was just a very pretty pots.
Wonderful.
Nice.
Tanya, hello from Alabama. And Sharmak, I can't wait to get my box. I think, as I recall, I just signed your packing slip this morning and it's shipping out today.
Came through this morning.
Julie as well. Can't wait to get my subscription box. It's a lot of fun. And, you know, we're coming into winter now and we're going to be growing indoors in our subscription boxes over the next couple of months. So don't think that that gardening stops in winter, because we've got the resources here to help you grow your groceries no matter how cold it is outside. It's going to be a ton of fun.
And Smart Pots crew, if you're on here as well, any feedback that you've received from anyone telling you all how much they like the box or not, that'd be cool.
Okay, 808 Ladybugs loves the pot. I think I'll use it for garden harvest. That's a great idea.
Good.
Also, love the the bonus or the surprise. So once you get your box, you're going to find out the surprise that's in there as well.
All right.
Got the bonus smart pot and a surprise in every single, a surprise in every single box. And this month's is a lot of fun too. Okay. Ramona says, I told my friend about you. She's beginning your shows. She's going to buy the October box. I haven't gotten mine yet. I'll be getting another for my aunt. She's 101 years old. Wow. That's crazy. And you can grab the gifted boxes this month too, which don't require a subscription. So if you know someone that's affected by breast cancer, it's a great time to do that.
Yeah, I want to read Bruce's comment here. The Breast Awareness Smart Pot box. My breast cancer survivor wife just checked into memory care until I will use it and bring it to her.
That is awesome, Bruce. Thank you so much. That means a lot to us.
It does.
It can help brighten your wife's day there. So thank you so much for sharing that. Okay. Mm. Yes.
Okay. I'm going to step off into the chat. I am Cliff's replacement for today.
Okay. Let's dig into October gardening. It's going to be a fun one today. October is a really fun month in the garden. A lot of you might be starting to wind things down for the fall and for the winter. I'd like to know here in the chat. I asked a little bit earlier. Let me mention that in just a moment when we get into our first point. But anyway, things might be slowing down in your garden. Maybe you're starting to pull things out. It's not quite of a busy month in the northern climates as it has been in the summertime when you're fast and furiously planting and harvesting. But it still can be a busy month in the south, because often in the south here, it's for southern gardeners, we're just getting going on our fall garden and our winter garden. So depending on where you live, you might be slowing down or you might be gearing up for some really nice cool weather gardening. But the first thing you really want to be aware of in the fall, especially if you live in those northern climates, keep an eye on that first frost date. So super, super important. And the reason why that is so important, because if you still have those warm weather vegetables in your garden, when the first frost comes, especially if it's a hard killing frost, it's going to kill your tomatoes, your peppers, your eggplant, your cucumbers. And you want to get out there and harvest all those vegetables before they get killed by the very first frost. So do make sure you pay attention to the weather. Check almanac.com, which is a really cool, handy tool over there. For the US and Canada, they have a frost date calculator. And what that basically means is you can pop in your zip code and you can get the average first and last frost dates in your area. And then you can kind of keep an eye on the weather, because it's not a hard and fast date, but just the average last frost date, so you know about when it'll be coming to your area. So do make sure you check on almanac.com and find out when your first frost date is, and keep an eye on it, especially in October. Some of you might be coming closer to that, you northern gardeners, maybe in the northern US and in Canada. Super, super important that you pay attention to that. So I want to know here in the chat, for those of us that are here today, who has the very first frost date coming up soon? So pop that in the chat. Let's find out who's getting colder. I know for us southern gardeners here, basically we live here in Southern California in a frost-free zone. I don't think we've had a frost probably for 3 or 4 years. If we ever do get frost, they're very, very light frosts. So if I've still got tomatoes in the garden by that point, they might get a little bit, cold damaged, but most often it's not a killing frost. So you can extend your crops by in the south, if you're getting cold temperatures, by covering with a little winter cover. And we'll talk about that in just a moment. But it can also be, besides being your worst enemy and killing some of your warm weather vegetables, it can also be a friend. And because it can make some of those cool weather veggies, and especially the root veggies, a little bit sweeter. So, things like carrots, beets, turnips, all the root vegetables, kale and chard, some of the greens even, they can take a light frost and it will make them even sweeter. So it can be your worst enemy, completely taking out your warm weather vegetables. But for the cool weather vegetables, as long as they're established and growing well, it can be your best friend and make those vegetables taste even sweeter. So no matter where you are, pay attention to the weather, whether it's frost date or whether you're just getting colder temperatures. Now, let me just bring up a little point here for Southern gardeners, because we did talk about planting a winter container garden in a video we posted last week. And we'll talk about that more in just a moment. But for you Southern gardeners who are still trying to grow some warm weather veggies over the winter, myself included, do pay attention to the temperatures. Because once it gets down in the, I'd say the 40s, we actually last night had 49 degrees, which is really cold for us anyway. Once it gets down into the 40s on a consistent basis, you are gonna wanna protect some of those cool or those warm weather vegetables. And we'll talk more about that in just a moment, because there's lots of different things you can use for cold protection. So even if you don't have frost, still pay attention to the temperature, and especially the nighttime temperatures in the south can really take out some of your plants, or at least damage them quite a bit. But there's lots of things you can do to help protect them. So we'll get into that more in just a moment. Okay, let's pop into the chat here. And I wanna know again, who has the very first frost date? Anyone have it in the next couple of weeks? Let me scroll back through here through the comments. And Sharmac, sometime between October 27th and November 10th. So that's definitely coming in the next few weeks. Jeff out in OKC, 1029. Brooklyn, new October 30th. So a lot of people coming up here in October. Wow, Nisha in Denver, October 15th. I'm from Denver and I had no idea it was coming up that soon in November. So I'll definitely have to let my dad know about that in case he's not aware. But he does have a cute little greenhouse that should help extend it just a little bit more. Let's scroll back through. So far, Denver is the soonest. Helen McClellan, October 20th. Let's see. Ann Bolin already had one. Oh my gosh. Okay. That takes the cake. Ann. And another one this Friday. And Ann, you'll have to remind me where you're from so we can warn the other gardeners that are up in the north, probably up in the north around you, to check into that. Okay, let's see here. Yeah, it's crazy, Anne. A high of 85, high of 46 this coming Friday. And I have to say, the temperature swings are all over the place here. Yesterday was 65. I think on Thursday or Friday, maybe Saturday, it's going to be in the mid-90s here as well. So the temperature is just all over the place here. So definitely do pay attention to the weather. And then, okay, northern Minnesota, Anne, wow, so you're kind of far up north there. So yeah, all you northern gardeners up in the northern U.S., definitely be paying attention to that. Gamester, October 10th in Caldwell, Idaho. And Nisha, I think you're right. I think Cliff also had one already. So hopefully, you northern gardeners are able to protect your vegetables just a little bit longer and keep them rolling right along. And Stephen Presley said, I also planted cucumbers 3 weeks ago and they are growing great and already producing. So yes, you southern gardeners may still be able to get away with planting some brand new plants and getting things rolling again for one last harvest, or at least to keep things producing throughout the winter time, depending on where you're at. So you really far south gardeners like Florida and Texas may be able to grow some of the warmer their vegetables even throughout the winter time. Still in the low 90s here in Texas. So yes, definitely the weather is crazy all over the place. Okay, let me talk now about, I did want to mention happen. Just so you can pop it on your calendars. Before I forget, we're not going to be live streaming on the 16th of October or the 23rd. And we'll be back again the following week, which I think is October 30th. So we have one more live stream. We'll be off for 2 weeks. And then the last week of November, we'll be back for the last live stream of November. Okay, so moving on to what to do here in October, essential garden to do number two. So I think a lot of you or a lot of people might think that gardening stops in winter, and it doesn't. If you've been around my channel very long, you know that we grow all year round, and I really encourage you to keep on growing, whether it's outdoors in a warmer winter climate throughout the wintertime, or indoors if you can't get outside to grow, if it's way too cold to grow outside. But there's also some things that you do want to be planting right now outside, pretty much no matter where you live. And the first thing is garlic. Garlic is really great to plant about 2 weeks before your first frost date. So those of you that have frost coming up in a couple of weeks, you can get out there and get your garlic planted 2 to 3 weeks before your first frost date is a great time to do it in the north. Southern gardeners, I usually plant mine about November, but you could pop it in now. But usually about November in my area here in Southern California is when the weather does start to kind of cool off. We don't get lots of, cold weather to have, so garlic doesn't really have that winter dormancy. But I've got a really great video on how to grow garlic in southern climates if you're wondering how to do that. But you northern gardeners, get it planted now. It might sprout just a little bit before it frosts, but then you're not going to see anything over the winter time. The garlic will be dormant over the winter, and when spring comes, it's going to start growing again, and you'll be harvesting it in June or July. But definitely get it planted now. It likes the cold temperature. The colder it is, the bigger bulbs you're going to have. So get some planted now. I usually just buy organic garlic at Trader Joe's and pop some of that in. But there's lots of online sources you can buy organic garlic, lots of different varieties. A lot of them sell out quickly though, so you may want to grab yours now and get your garlic planted. The other thing you can do is go crazy planting flower bulbs. Usually about 6 weeks before a hard frost is a good time to plant those flower bulbs, so you have very, 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 very early spring blooms. So I'm talking things like bulbs like tulips, daffodils, crocus, hyacinth. I'm trying to think of some other good spring bulbs here. I wrote a couple other ideas down. Those are the main ones that I can think of. If you know of any other really early spring flowers that you can plant bulbs for now in the fall, pop them in the chat. Let's hear what your favorite ones are. But they also need that winter period of dormancy. And then a lot of times, even before your last frost of the spring, when you get a couple of sunny days in a row, those little winter blooms or early spring bulbs will be popping through, and you'll have some early winter or spring blooms, which is always such a lift during the early spring months when the ground has been covered in snow to see those early flowers popping through. So definitely do that and get those bulbs out there planted, get the garlic planted out there. And in your southern climates, November is a really good time to plant garlic, and you can pretty much plant flower bulbs anytime. But right now I've been planting a lot of perennial flower seeds and just throwing them down. I'm pulling out old flowers that are spent and throwing down new seeds so it can bloom and really get going over the winter time and then really start blooming here in the spring. So definitely get out there, plant your garlic, plant your bulbs. Now, for you northern gardeners, you want to get your indoor garden going. Now's the time to do that. And you can just have a super easy indoor winter garden during the summer or during the winter time, where you can grow your greens, you can grow some herbs, you can grow some little smaller type of vegetables. I wouldn't recommend growing like a full-size tomato or cucumber plant inside. It just takes too much space and you need too many grow lights, but keep it simple. And we are our October Grow Your Groceries box is especially designed for that. So in those, you'll be growing a little miniature tomato, which is super cute. I don't know if I brought one out here with me today, but it's only about a 6 to 8 inch tomato. You'll also be growing some little miniature peas as well as some herbs. So that box, the theme is indoor mini vegetables and herbs. Because what is better than harvesting something steps from your kitchen and when it's too cold to get outside? So definitely get that indoor garden growing now. For you northern gardeners, or you southern gardeners, I'm sorry, now's the perfect time to get fall seeds planted. So we're actually supposed to get in the mid-90s this week. I plan to get my a lot of my fall garden planted this week. I've got tons of greens that are kind of hardening off right here that I've been starting in the house, some fall vegetables. But with hot weather coming, I think I'll wait one more week on that and just kind of work on getting them hardened off this week and ready to plant next week. Fingers crossed, it'll cool down. But southern gardeners, if you want to plant, and I highly recommend this, to plant a super easy winter container vegetable garden. We've got one planted right back here. We just did a video on that on Friday. And I would definitely mix it up. Plant some another round of determinate tomatoes in the south. We've got a really nice determinate tomato plant right over here. And this is one that sets fruit in cold temperatures. It's called a Celeste tomato. And you can go back and watch the video for how to get that planted. Got some greens planted and some herbs. So if you don't want to get out and plant all your raised beds again, just grab some of these 15-gallon smart pots. This is a 3-pack that you can get over at Costco.com. It's super reasonable. I think it's maybe like around $29.99 over at Costco.com. So really great way to put just to plant an all-in-one container garden that fits right here on your patio. So super easy, super convenient, and you're going to absolutely love just stepping right outside your back door and picking some of these plants. And I'm really excited about this because literally my kitchen door is about 5 steps in front of me. So, you know, when it's cold and rainy, I don't always feel like getting down to the garden, but I can grab some greens, some herbs, and some tomatoes right outside and then bring them indoors and pop them in my recipe. So highly recommend southern gardeners get those fall veggies planted and then plant yourself a winter container vegetable garden. Super convenient. And one thing I love about this too is our deck tends to get a little bit shaded during the winter time. So because they have handles, I can move them around really easily, move them into the sun. So they're really productive. So let me know in the chat here now what you're going to be planting this week. So let's set ourselves a goal to plant something, even just one thing this week. So I want to know in the chat, what are you going to be planting this week, whether you're in the north or the south? And let's just keep on growing our groceries as much as we can during the month of October. Okay, let's see. Bruce, do you line the grow your groceries box with anything before planting it? No, I don't. All I do is just put soil in it, and I don't really think about it too much. I pretty much plant it up like I would any other container, like a Smart Pots container, and it usually will last. I love growing it in there. I think it's really cute and pretty. It usually will last a couple of months. I think I transplanted the vegetables I had in here last month into a larger container and then put the October vegetables in here. And the box is kind of starting to fall apart a little bit, but once it falls apart, I'll transplant those vegetables and then just pop the box in the compost because it's made out of cardboard, so you can throw them in the compost pile. But it's a really fun way to grow. And these have actually been under my grow lights. So I put them in a little tray to catch all the drips. So great question on that. Okay, Ann Boland, I just washed my 1-gallon Smart Pots, and once dry, I will be growing lettuce and microgreens indoors. So great way to grow. It's a nice small container, and you can grow, that's perfect size for lettuce and micros. And great idea on throwing them in the washer. They wash up very, very nicely. I just washed a whole bunch last week and then air dried it. They're nice and clean, look brand new, and they're ready to go for a fresh new crop of vegetables in it. Okay, oh my goodness, Ecocentric Homestead, too busy harvesting. Big garden, first average frost date is tomorrow. So yeah, definitely an important time to get out there and harvest those veggies. And then after that, maybe you can think about getting some an indoor garden going there. Okay, backyard garden flow 21. Question, is it okay to keep my garlic in the fridge until ready to plant them? And yes, that's actually what I do here is when I get garlic, I usually pop it in the fridge or the freezer. I think the fridge actually is a better choice is what I did for a couple of weeks before I plant them because this kind of simulates cold temperatures. So it works well for southern gardeners. If you do that, if you live in the north, you can still pop them in the fridge and then just put them outside when you're ready to plant. Okay, Patricia is planting this week. Cucumbers, herbs, tiny Tims, and salad greens will be planted this week. And she's in Arizona, where you're just coming into your cooler season after a super hot summer. So those are all good things. And I know Patricia loves gardening in the fall and in the winter in Arizona, because it's so much more pleasant to garden when it's cooler out there. Okay, let's see. Someone just asked a question about washing. Coco Bryn girl, I think. Do you wash the smart pots on the gentle cycle? No, I don't. I actually wash them on the heavy duty cycle, because that way it spins them faster and gets all the dirt or the hard water stains out of them. And sometimes they might have to run it through twice, and then they are almost dry by the time they come out. They usually just take a few hours to dry and you're good to go. Okay, Bruce is also transplanting lettuce, started indoors, to a raised bed. So it's a great way to do that as well. Okay, let's jump back into our tip number three on what to do here in October. And that is one of my favorite fall things to do is save your leaves. I can't emphasize that enough. For a lot of you, you might be getting those fall colors. We don't get them much here, but you might be getting those fall colors now on your trees, and the leaves are starting to fall down. Don't throw your leaves away. Do not put them in the trash or put the bags out on the curb. Gardeners need to save our leaves, every single leaf that you can. And the reason for that is they are a very rich source of organic matter for your garden beds. So what you can do with your leaves is you can put them in a trash can, use your safety goggles, grab your weed whacker, and whack them up into small pieces. And then you can put them on your garden beds or use them to mulch your containers. They absolutely are wonderful for your garden beds. They are a great source of organic matter. They break down over the winter time, and the worms absolutely love them. So several years ago, I started doing that, or mulching with shredded leaves. And I could not believe, once I dug into those garden beds, how many more worms I had. And of course, worms are great for your garden beds. They break up your heavy soil. They deposit their worm castings in the soil. When you see worms in your garden beds, the little brown earthworms, that is, that's always a good sign. So however you can to beg, borrow, or steal leaves, rake your leaves up from your grass or from your yard. You can even run them over with a lawnmower to shred them up. Go around to your neighbors and collect leaves, or just pile them up in a corner of your backyard. Now's a great time during October to save your leaves. And if you live in a southern climate, once the winds come here in California, usually around November, a lot of our leaves, that's when they start blowing off the trees. And we're always, just putting them, we keep them in actually a big 100-gallon Smart Pots compost sack. And then I use them as needed all year long. So now's my time too to collect the leaves that I'll have for the next year, because that's primarily the time of year that we get our leaves. So definitely you always want to save your leaves, either compost with them or put them on your garden beds.
Okay, I just posted a question in the chat, so you're going to answer it in the main comments. But the question is this: of the 3 points so far, which one resonated with you the most? That is either first frost or plant up or save leaves. So it's kind of interesting to see who had an aha moment there. Oh, I never thought about that. So put those in the main comments right now. Can you make the comments come up there, Kim?
Yep.
We can kind of read them in real time. It's always kind of fun to see.
Scroll by here. Mm-hmm. Bruce, composting, definitely.
Okay, cool. So the question is of the three points so far, which one has resonated most with you so far? And there's three more to come. So
Charmac is ahead of us, says number six.
Hey, how does she know?
We'll get to that in just a moment. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Laura, saving leaves too. Wow. Lots of people are saving leaves.
Yep.
Okay. Ecocentric lawnmower didn't work. Then just try something else. Maybe the weed whacker, or any way that you can get them broken down into a smaller size.
Very cool. I remember when we moved here, we went to the park and got a bunch of leaves. You remember that?
We did. Yeah. I think we might have made a video about
it. Yeah, we did make a video out of that. Yeah. We filmed there and everything. All right. A lot of people saying leaves and stuff.
That's right. Becky, planting for fall and winter. So great time to do that.
All right. Well, make sure you stick around to the end. I've made an infield play change here, so I'll tell you more at the end.
All right, sounds good. And I did want to mention too that we have lots of resources on our website to help you plant this month. We did make like a featured seed collection section, so you kind of know, like, you know, during the appropriate season what seeds you need to be planting. Right now, cool weather vegetables for most people would be the fall garden seed collection, indoor garden for a lot of you. So all of my seed collections are arranged by type of vegetable or growing season, so you know what to plant. Greens are always a great thing to plant, in the lettuce seed collection, the kale, or the specialty green selection or collection are all good things to plant right now. So grab those. And of course, the sub box is always, I always have seasonal seeds and item, fun items in there for to keep you going. Okay, another thing to do during October, and a lot of places, a lot of areas can do this, is stock up on your supplies, because lots of garden centers, they don't know you can garden in the winter, and they run clearance sales at this time of the year. So now's a great time to check, even like a Walmart, Target, your local garden centers might even be running clearance sales, but to stock up on bags of soil, fertilizers, organic soil amendments, that type of thing, liquid fertilizers, even pest control products. So check around at your local areas, and a lot of times you can really get a great deal. So you're not buying during peak season, and you can really stock your garden sheds for next spring. So I would highly recommend you do that this year. A lot of places are having seed sales, and all kinds of clearance sales. So now is a great time to stock up. We'll be running some more sales on our seed collections throughout the month of October. So definitely pay attention and stock up while you can. Why not save money and put your resources into other things that you could use it for? Just make your money go further. So possibly even like garden tools, garden equipment, maybe certain things that you have been looking at purchasing but have been putting off. Now's a great time to check into that, as long as you have the space to store it until next spring. I would highly recommend that you start stocking up, and you can also use them for Christmas gifts for your friends. So crazy to think that Christmas is just around the corner. So anyway, tip number four is stock up. So let me know in the chat here if you've been able to find some really great deals, because that way we can help each other along with that as well. Bruce says they move garden supplies out of the big box stores for Halloween, so start looking mid-September. That's right. Even the Christmas decorations are already coming out, so they're already starting to do a lot of clearance sales. So keep an eye on that. Julie says, I've been buying seeds and trellises, making materials at sales, including tractor supply for next spring. So yeah, a lot of us love those clearance sales, so keep on going on that. Julie stocked up on smart pots, so never too early to start buying Christmas gifts as well. Smart pots, as well as our box here for this month, would make a great Christmas gift. Okay, Patricia just got notified her sub box was delivered. It's always delivered during the live streams. You know what you'll be doing after the live, so absolutely. And make sure that you watch the, you get an exclusive, a link to a video in the box on how to plant it. So make sure you watch that one and get your box planted up. Okay, so number five for what to do during the month of October is make sure that you're doing some winter prep for your garden. Okay. For the north, you may be able to overwinter some plants. So a lot of strawberries can be overwintered, and you do want to prepare your strawberries for overwintering. And that would be cutting them back, leaving in the crown and maybe a little bit of growth on top of the crown, but then mulching them heavily and with at least 2 to 3 inches of shredded leaves. Again, saving those leaves or some type of straw mulch, some type of mulch, and helping them to survive over the winter time. So definitely want to do that. Some pepper plants too. If you have a couple favorite pepper plants, you northern gardeners, even your southern gardeners, can either dig them up. Southern gardeners can pretty much cut them back and mulch them right in place, and they'll survive most often over the winter time. Northern gardeners, you want to dig them up, replant them in a container, maybe put them in your garage or in a sheltered location to overwinter your plants, get some mulch around them, and definitely start preparing some of your plants for overwintering. And even if you have a couple favorite container plants you'd like to bring inside, you want to hose them down real well, get any insects off them, maybe transplant them in a container with some fresh soil and bring them into the house. So that's always a good thing to do. Maybe you have a special basil plant you want to move indoors during the winter, citrus trees, those types of things you can move inside so you can have some of those during the winter months. And definitely want to compost and mulch your garden beds. That way, over the winter time, all that good compost and mulch breaks down and helps make your spring garden beds very ready to roll. Okay, you also want to get some winter covers ready. So get some of that heavy-duty plastic, some old quilts, so you can extend your season just a little bit if you want to. So if you've got a frost coming and you want to get your tomato plants to maybe last just a little bit longer, grab yourself an old quilt, a little easy winter cover, and just kind of wrap it around your tomato plant. And that can help it last just a little bit longer so you get a little bit more out of it. Of course, depending on the temperature. Southern gardens will have a lot more success with that. Northern gardens, hard freezes, even that will probably not save your tomato plant. So just keep it real and manage your expectations on that one. If you want to really, really protect your plants and prepare for winter, you could always build yourself a really heavy duty cold frame or put up a greenhouse. That's always a good solution. But that's, of course, a little bit more work. So if you're not quite prepared to do that, then just grab yourself some old sheets, winter blankets, thick, heavy duty plastic, and get ready to prepare your garden for wintertime. Okay, let's see here. I think we pretty much covered that. So let's talk about in the chat if any of you are, you know, getting those winter covers out and what vegetables you're going to be looking to protect in your garden over the winter time. Okay, Ann says, I'm going to overwinter lavender. It's risky, but I'm going to try it here in Minnesota. So yeah, you might want to just make sure that you heavily, heavily mulch your lavender plant. I'd say even 3 to 4 inches of mulch if you want. And you know what? It's always worth an experiment. It'll grow fine in mid to southern climates over the winter time, but give it a try. The worst thing that can happen is it'll die and you might have to buy a new plant next spring, but that way you'll know for next year what works and what doesn't. Okay, Terry, great suggestion here. She's also in Southern California. I've been using camping or beach tarps to cover my plants in the last couple of years. They're weighted, but still let air come through, and they may be on sale now. So yeah, great time to pick up those tarps and things that you can use for winter covers. Okay, learning to overwinter pepper plants is high on the priority list here. It's a great thing to do, Ecocentric, because then come springtime, you're starting, not only have you saved money by not having to buy pepper plants in the spring at the garden center, but you are starting with plants rather than seeds. You still want to start seeds indoors, but you got a little bit of a jump with that. Okay, Keystone Garden Mama. She is going to move container strawberries into the garage. So yeah, that's a great thing to do for you northern gardeners, is just put them into the garage and just water them enough to keep them alive. You don't want to bring them out of dormancy. It's a little bit too chilly for that. But that's always a good thing to do as well. Okay, Ramona Jolly, should I cut the green parts off the strawberry plants as well? Well, Ramona, as the weather cools down where you live, your strawberry greenery is going to die. So yeah, if you're getting ready to overwinter and you want to go ahead and do that now, I would just go ahead and prune them all back. Maybe leave, you know, an inch or so of growth above the crown and then mulch and prepare for overwintering and you should be good to go. Okay, we do have one other point here that you want to pay attention to during the month of October, and that is garden cleanup. Terry, yes, I think I do have a video on that. So just search strawberry on my channel and you should find a video on how to overwinter your strawberry plants. But pretty much just follow the steps I just mentioned and you'll be good to go. All right, so number 6 to do during October is to start cleaning up your garden if you haven't yet. It sounds like a lot of you are starting to do that, but you do want to start cleaning out some of those old plants so you're not attracting a lot of the rodents, a lot of the pests. So if you've got old tomato plants, pull them out. And not only will it make your garden, you know, look a lot nicer, but if you live in a southern climate, it's going to start clearing out your garden beds, preparing for fall and winter planting. So if you do a little bit of that each day, it won't be quite so overwhelming and you won't have quite so much garden waste to get rid of. I know for me, a lot of my tomato plants got spider mites this year. So they went into the green trash bin, which we have a green pickup every week. But my cans get full when I have tons and tons to pull out. So do a little bit every week, and that way you can make the most of your green can space. Or if they're not pest and disease infested, you can put them in your compost pile. And that way you can really get the compost going over the winter. And yes, you still can compost over winter, even if you live in an area that you get hard freezes. It'll just thaw and freeze and thaw and freeze and just accelerate the breaking down of the compost that much quicker. So still save your kitchen scraps and your garden waste to compost over the wintertime. You're probably seeing a lot of your perennials die back by now in the north, your perennial flowers especially, so you can go ahead and prune those way back and clean those up. And you could always mulch them as well. You're also going to start seeing your berries and your grapes go dormant when the leaves start to dry up and the canes start to dry up. You can go ahead and cut those back, and that way they're all set for coming back again in the spring. And you can pull your spent plants and just go through and kind of daily, maybe spend 15 or 20 minutes. Just cleaning out your flower beds. Now, that being said, there are some things I really like to leave in because we love seeing the birds and the bees have some food for the winter. So case in point is back here. I don't know if it will show on camera if it'll be too bright, but I've got a whole bunch of sunflowers. I don't think it's going to show. A whole bunch of sunflowers that are starting to die off. But we love sitting up here on our deck and seeing the birds come in, and they like to hang upside down actually on the sunflowers and just peck at the little seeds. So it's kind of nice to leave some in so the birds have some food for the wintertime. But definitely go through, and the dahlias, a lot of the dahlia big flowers are dying off. So you can, in the south, you want to make sure you still deadhead your flowers because you might still get some bloom time. So it's kind of that back and forth of, is my plant done or will I be able to get a little bit more out of it? So that's a call you're going to have to make. We've done lots of videos on how to decide that, and then just go for it and start cleaning out your garden beds and getting them kind of spruced up and mulched and composted and ready for the winter. Okay, guys, that is our tips for today. So I want to know here in the chat, we've got lots of things for you to do here this week and during the month of October. Wow, Cliff is here. All right, he popped in between the things he had going on today. So thanks a lot, Cliff. But let us know here in the chat what you're going to be doing this week. You got plenty now on your to-do list. So hopefully that helped you narrow some of the essentials down. All right, Jerry, you coming? I see you got
Yeah, I'll come out now. And I want to remind you all, if you open your subscription boxes, tag Kim and I and Smart Pots and show us your subscription box and what part you liked the most, and do that on Instagram. I think that would be really, really, really cool to see. I also want to just show
you Callie Camera Guy and Callie Kim on Instagram.
Yes, Callie Camera Guy and Callie Kim, right? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, well, look what I found. I just thought, okay, I'm going to show this to you right here. This is that candy bar I was talking to you all about. It's called the Idaho Spud. I think. I'm not too sure what that part is, but it says here on the side, the candy bar that makes Idaho famous. So I want you to put in the chat right now. Cliff says, oh, yeah. I want you to put in the chat right now if you want to see Kim and I take a bite of this. Right now, live here on the Instagram. It's lunchtime out here in California. So let me see it. Say yes in the chat right now if you want to see us open this and take a bite. Charlene Mitchell, spud is potato for us Brits. Okay, let's see.
Yeah, it's
there's a yes. There's the yeses are coming in.
Man, look at all those yeses.
Oh my gosh. Okay, just do it. Yeah, we're gonna do it. All right, here we go.
I don't know if I keep the whole thing, but a bite, yes.
Yeah, again, have no idea what to expect.
Oh wow,
look at this.
It's white. It's totally different than I thought it would be. I guess the potato is white, right? Most of them.
Wow.
Kind of cool looking.
Is that coconut?
I'm not sure.
Okay, Kim.
What's inside?
This is your hat.
Oh, it even looks like a potato. See the shape, Jerry?
Oh, it's shaped like a potato.
Here we go. Cheers.
All right. Yeah, I guess.
Oh, my goodness.
It tastes like a potato.
Wow. It's like a little marshmallow.
Coconut. Cliff versus coconut.
Okay. Chocolate covered potato, basically. Marshmallow.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's puffy.
Yeah, it is.
And it does. Well, I kind of have potato here.
It's pretty good. It's not at all what I expected. I thought it would be
me neither.
Solid chocolate.
I thought it was too. Look at that.
Idaho did good with these. All right. I'm going to save mine for for after lunch, but that's a good one, Jerry. We should have got another one while we were there.
Yeah, that was really cool. Thanks for sticking around. Yeah, I definitely need something to drink right now. My mouth is like a
poof. For sure. Melted over ice cream, says Scott. Water time.
Nice. Okay.
All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. We'll have our lunch and then finish the rest of it. All right. Camera is already done with his half. All right, guys. Thanks so much for hanging out with us. We'll be back again next Monday. Couple videos in between. And hope you guys have a great week.
Talk to you later.
All right. See ya. Bye-bye.
Bye.